us, the church, amen, that they cast their cares, amen, on the Lord, just as he cares for you. But also, amen, he's talking to the elders, he's talking to those, amen, that are part of the body of Christ and the things that they ought to do one to another. We begin to look at this, amen, this passage of scripture. My thought for this morning, amen, is very simple, but it's unique because a lot of times when people are going through, they fail to ask, amen, God for help. So it says, don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help. A lot of times, amen, you can find yourself struggling with something that is heavy, amen, and you can say, I got it, knowing that you need help. A lot of times, amen, we can be going through the grocery store and somebody's trying to reach up on the top shelf, and we'll say, can I help you with that, amen? And the person within themselves can say, A, yes, or B, no. And most of the time, they say, yes, because they realize, amen, it's something that's too high that they can't be reaching for. As a matter of fact, there's a sign even that says on the top shelf, it says, ask for help, amen, if you want something from this top shelf, amen. How many, amen, need something from the Lord on this morning? Amen? How many, amen, need something, amen, that only you know that God can help you with, amen? So we begin to look at the scripture here, amen, and there's something very unique about it. You say, why is it asking for help? Because, amen, there's a couple of words here, amen, and I don't believe in playing on words, man, but there's some words here, amen, that we got to have a true understanding and meaning what God is trying to say to us on this morning, amen. The first one, amen, when he deals with, he said, being clothed, amen, being clothed with humility, amen. So clothed, amen, is mean to endow with a particular quality, amen, to be endowed with a particular quality, amen. So clothed, amen, humility is the clothing that we should be putting on, amen. And so what happened is among the saints of God, that word, amen, humility, amen, it also brings about something that the saints of God sometimes in our lives, amen, feel like it's a show of weakness. But for the body of Christ, amen, this word humility, amen, has to do with the strength of God that lies within us through the power of the Holy Ghost. And so humility, amen, is a modest, a lowered state of one's own importance, amen. It's being respectful and it's being submissive. And so therefore we begin to look at Peter, he begins to write this, you find the words and submit yourselves one to the other. And so what begins to happen, amen, with the body of Christ, we live in a world now that people, amen, A, don't want to submit to authority. They don't want, amen, someone to tell them to slow down, you're going too fast. They don't want somebody to tell them, amen, you're going down the wrong road. You need to stop and make a complete U-turn. Because what happened here is saints of God. We begin to look at the scripture, amen, very carefully. There's something, amen, that happens, amen, that calls people that don't want to be humble into the house of God. There's something, amen, in our lives, amen, that calls people, amen, that don't want to submit to the word and to the will of God. And so that word, amen, he said, cast all your cares upon him. And so that word, amen, cares, it has to do, amen, with anxiety, amen. Sometimes people suffer from anxiety. If I tell the saints of God, I'm going to give you a pop quiz on Tuesday night, amen. Somebody not going to sleep tonight. Realize, amen, they got a pop quiz on Tuesday. In other words, amen, the anxiety, amen, that you feel, amen, calls you to do not to do the things that you should be doing. And so therefore, when we look at the word humility, it begins to tell us a couple of things, amen. It tells us, amen, that we got to submit ourselves, that it cannot be about us. And so therefore, when he said being clothed, amen, with humility, amen, said we got to put on the Lord Jesus Christ so we don't make no provision for this flesh. But this flesh, saints of God, is enmity against the will of God. It cannot be subject, amen, to the word and to the will of God. And so therefore, as saints of God, it's imperative for us that we, amen, that we be led and guided by the Spirit of God, which is the Holy Ghost. And so he begins to tell the elders, he said, which are more than exalt whom also an elder. He said, listen, a witness of the suffering of Jesus Christ. He said, listen, there's something, amen, that you have got to do. He said, feed the flock which is among you, amen. He said, take no oversight thereof. And so therefore, as saints of God, we are the people of God. We are the bride of Christ. But we're now, amen, coming to a time time, amen, that the enemy has begun to turn up the heat, it's very important for us, amen, that we seek the will of God that's in our lives, amen. That we walk, amen, contrary to the world, amen, but we walk circumspect to the world, to the will of God. Meaning, amen, if you find yourself walking with the crowd, glory be to God, if you find yourself ushering about with a crowd of folks, my God, you might find yourself on the wrong road, glory be to God. But if you find yourself going against the grain, going against the norm, amen, then you can look and say, Lord, am I in your will? Because a lot of people, amen, they think that I'm on my way to heaven anyway, because I check the box, amen, on Sunday morning and say, yes, I want the church, yes, amen, but I want the saints of God this morning to realize that the church is not a check in the box, glory be to God. The church, my God, is part of you, it's all of you, it's about Jesus Christ and him being crucified. So showing up on Sunday morning and checking the box is not what God wants from us. God wants all of us. God wants us, amen, to magnify his name. He wants to lift them up, amen, before a dying world. He wants to get the glory out of our lives. So a check in the box is not just glorifying God. It's satisfying man. It's satisfying the flesh. And yes, I did what I was supposed to do on this morning. So it's not on your to-do list. Amen. Glory be to God. Go to church today. I've done that so I can feel good about myself. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, he called me out of darkness into his marvelous light. I want to tell somebody about this man called Jesus. I want to tell somebody, amen, how he brought me out of this darkness. I just didn't show up here on this morning. It took somebody, amen, to witness to me and to tell me about this man called Jesus. It took somebody to convince me that I was a sinner, a wretch undone. And if I die today, amen, I find myself, amen, in a living hell, glory be to God. But now I begin to realize that the joy of the Lord has become my strength. If I fall asleep, I'll fall asleep in the Lord. And so therefore, saints of God, when he begins to talk about, don't be afraid to ask for help. If you're going through something on this morning, whatever minute it might seem, don't be afraid to ask. Say, Lord, I need some help with this situation. I'm struggling, my God, in finances. I'm struggling being obedient. I'm struggling being on time. I'm having a struggle, amen, with my children. I'm having a struggle in my marriage. In other words, saints of God, in the natural, we ask for help. Yes, we will. We'll ask for help. But what happens sometimes when you find out that some people that don't want to ask for help, there's something in it down in the inside of them. They're too proud to ask, amen, for some help, glory be to God. But let you find yourself, amen, drowning, my God. The first thing they cry out, help, our God. I thank and praise God. And the body of Christ will help us one to another. Sometimes the look, it might not be audible, but sometimes it's just the look on somebody's face. You got to discern, amen, just what help really is. Our little sister on this morning, she came through the door with tears in her eyes. In other words, I could listen, you're going to be okay, but you got to take time and say, come on in, let's figure it out. What's going on in your life, glory be to God. As you begin to tell me the thing, I said, well, let's go ahead and pray. Glory be to God. And lo and behold, God began to answer prayer. This is what I'm talking about. It's not just about the adults as well. It's about our children, glory be to God. And sometimes they don't know what it is that they need. But she needs to have a little talk with Jesus on the morning. She needs to be in touch with somebody that can put her in touch with the man. Hallelujah. I'm not patting myself on the back, but when I'm trying to get the saints of God to understand, there's people that are in our midst that are going through, and we gotta have enough sympathy of the Spirit of God to say what it is that you need help with. And sometimes as saints of God, we gotta have a Holy Ghost boldness to ask for help, glory be to God. I'm looking for God to do some marvelous things in the house of God, but I'm not here trying to do it on my own. I'm gonna need some help, glory be to God. I'm gonna need some faithful deacons. I'm gonna need some faithful ushers. I'm gonna need the house of God to be faithful, amen, unto the will and to the work of God. So begin to look at this thing. So sometimes what happened is we fail to be humble, my God, because it threatens who we are. Glory be to God. It takes me out of who I am, and it calls me to be submissive to the will of God. He said, not mine.
Glory be to God. I'm so commanded of the commercial that goes on. The young man, he's at the airport, and they said, listen, your clothes, the suitcase are too heavy. It's going to cost you a whole lot of money. And lo and behold, the person began to take the clothes out of the suitcase, and they began to put them on. Glory be to God, because he don't want to pay the price for what it is to cause that suitcase to get on that plane. So I'm going to humiliate myself with all these clothes on and to pay the price. Saints of God, you got to be willing to pay the price for the suffering of Jesus Christ. And that's why he says, I'm an eyewitness of the suffering of Christ as those, my God, that's going to be named among Christ. This is a suffering way. Yes, it is. But you got to be humble. Glory be to God. What are you talking about, Pastor? Sometimes, saints of God, you're going to make a mistake here and there. But what it is, when you make that mistake, can you say, I'm sorry and I was wrong? See, that's what humbleness does. Humbleness recognizes the situation that that the meaning that I caused it. I caused harm to you by the word that flew from my mouth. I caused harm to you by my action that I took. And I'm not so saved and sanctified that I can say, hey, I'm sorry. I did you wrong. That's what humbleness is. And so when he said, being clothed in all humility, in other words, I got to take off the deeds of this flesh and put on the Lord Jesus Christ, who was humble among all men. The first thing, saints of God, sometimes that comes to your mind, and the last thing that goes through your mind, that's the thing sometimes that the adversary wants to use. He wants to use your very thoughts against you. That's why he said, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's what humbleness means. It means being in a lower state. Saints of God, I want you to realize that there's some things that trouble us on this morning. Yes, it is. But whatever it is, that things that cause anxiety, that things that make the cares that you're so concerned about, that it cannot get you to move on behalf of God. Sometimes we go to bed with things on our mind, and we toss and turn all night long. And sometimes we wake up with that very thing on our mind. Yes, we do. And so sometimes, saints of God, that very thing that's showing you, that's the care that God is trying to get you to cast upon him. Glory be to God. I remember the movies when they said the Westerns, they used to have these donkeys. Yes, they did. They call them pack mules, as a matter of fact. And you look at that mule, he got all that stuff packed on his back, but he's carrying the load. Yes, he is, because that's what he was bred to do. That's what he was designed to do. And so, saints of God, God is a God. In the Bible says he's a heavy load bearer. That's what the word of God begins to say. He said, I carry the load, but before I can carry it, you got to have enough humility to cast the cares on me, because I care for you. Listen, what God is saying, it's not enough just to cast your cares, but he says, the promise is, I care for you. In other words, all you that are laden, heavy laden, come unto me, and I will give you rest. Saints of God, when you find no rest for your very soul, take a look back and say, am I casting my cares? Am I casting my anxieties? Am I casting the very things that keep me up at night? Am I casting on the Lord? And not only am I casting on him, am I leaving there? And so we begin to realize there's a thing that's going to happen in the lives of the saints of God. But he says in Peter, he said, God resists the proud. But he's not talking about us, those that are proud, those that won't allow God to move in our lives. When you want God to move, you got to ask for help and say, God, this burden is too heavy for me to bear. Don't be afraid to ask for some help. I thank and praise God for the little things they have now. It's called Life Alert. It's the saints of God, the elderly people that's in this world. Now, my God, they can still live alone by themselves, because when they fall, they click the little button and it helps them right there, just when you need her. What is the button are you pushing on this morning? Is it a button of panic, or the witness that when I call on the Lord, who's able, my God, to lift me up when I feel like I'm going down for the last help? But God is. He's a very present helper in the time of broken heart. You know, great, big, wonderful God. And you know, take them. Yes, you will. But I got to take off, my God, self-sufficiency. What does it mean? That I can handle because of my own strength. It means that I can do things by myself. We pray for our young children because they get to a point now they can do it on their own. Yes, they do. We've had toddlers that grew up and said, no, they be happy. I don't need no help. As little they are, they think they know it all. But glory be to God. And sometimes saints of God think we know it all. But God said, I know the thoughts and the plans that I have for you. God has worked it out for your good. It might not look like it for the outside looking in, but those that are named among the body of Christ, you tell them it's working out for my good. I always have the vision of pastor when he walked on the cross here. He was sick in his body. Yes, he was. My God, he had lost all his weight. But he said, it does not look good, but it's all God. You need to tell somebody, this is all God. This is the Lord's doing. So saints of God, when you chase him by the Lord, begin to realize, he said, I'm chasing those whom I love. If God loves you, he's going to chase you. And so therefore, I remember my mother telling me, this is going to hurt me as more is going to hurt you. Glory be to God. What kind of sense is that? I'm the one that feels the aches and pains. But I begin to realize when you get children of your own, you hate to put them in that situation because all the teachings of the things we try to tell you is heard to us that it has come down to this. Glory be to God. And sometimes God says that it comes down to this. Listen, saints of God, some of the things that we might be going through is of our own doing. Sometimes, yes, the enemy might come in like a flood, but is it of my own doing? Am I where I'm supposed to be? When I'm supposed to be there? Because sometimes, saints of God, when I find myself going down the wrong road, because there's a sign that says one way, and I'm going just the opposite, and with the way the word of God is saying, that's contrary to the will of God. There's a natural sign when you turn and says, do not enter. And what does it mean? It means stop, turn around, don't go in that direction, because you might not see the immediate danger, but you're causing danger to yourself and to somebody else. And what am I saying for the saints of God on this morning? We were not connected to God because I want you to realize something, saints. This is very important for us on this morning because it's going to help us get through these next few months and before this end of this year. If the Lord tarry, we got to realize that God knows all things. So therefore, as a body, we got to maintain our connection to God and to one another. What am I trying to say? Sometimes the power might go out in your house. It's no time to have a lights out party. It's time to begin to pray and take time with the Lord and say, God, what are you trying to say to me with my power being out? We're so frustrated because our favorite show is on. No, how can the power go out when the world is about to come on? But God is trying to tell you, I'm trying to make a connection with you by breaking your connection with the world. Glory be to God. And so what God is saying, I'm trying to put you in the word of God. I'm trying to cause you to suck up me. I'm trying to cause you to feel what I'm saying. I'm trying to breathe life into your situation because I got somebody on the other side of the street, on the other side of town. I got somebody to sit next to you every day that needs to hear what I'm trying to drop in your spirit. Glory be to God. That's the connection that God is trying to give us. God is trying to make a connection with us, but we're so complaining because the power is out. You take that time to pray. You take that time to seek the Lord. You take time and say, God, what's the connection? The connection is that God has made a promise. He said, cast all of your cares upon me because I care for you. Yeah, we got loved ones that need to be saved, but when you can sit in the house of God and not respond to the word of God, it's not on you, it's on them. Glory be to God. But you being a man of God, you continue to pray, you continue to intercede, you ask God, give me the words that I can speak to him, and not unto him, but speak to his family. But we got to lift him up in prayer because he was named among the body of Christ, and so therefore he's a name among us. It's our responsibility to pray one for another. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Sometimes we have job interviews. We say what it is that I need to say, because every interview is lead up to one question and leads to another. Say, how do I approach this interview? In other words, don't lie. Glory be to God. Don't fabricate nothing. Tell it like it is. It's the same thing that you put on your application. It's the same questions that he's asking you. And sometimes it might be 3 months before they called you in. And I'm here to tell you, saints of God, when you fill out an application, I don't know who I'm helping on this morning, but when you fill it out, glory be to God, you ask for a copy of it for yourself. And so when they call you in, you can know exactly what it is that you put on there. You might not remember what you wrote 3 months ago, but as long as you got it right in your head, that's what the word of God says. We got it. It's nigh thee in the hearts. He said, hide the word of God in our hearts, that you might not sin against you. What it is that we treasure that word, it doesn't mean to put it somewhere we can't find it. It's to hide it. You know when you find a good thing and you don't want nobody to take it, you put it in a special place. And God is saying, your heart is a special place. In other words, out of the heart flows the issues of life. If I got life, which is the word of God, then I'm going to speak life into a dead situation. I'm not going to harm you when words come from my mouth, because I got the word of God down on the inside of me. It's a burning fire just for your situation. But don't be afraid to ask for help. And when I ask for help, it's not me, but the Holy Ghost that's down the inside. He is doing the work. And so, saints of God, whatever it is that you're going through, allow God to do his perfect work. And that's why he began to tell the elders. He said, I was a witness of the suffering of Christ. In other words, he's telling you, see, I can only preach and teach about the things that I have seen and heard and watch him do. What are we trying to say? If you went through something, tell somebody how you made it over. It was by the power of God. It was by a saint of God coming alongside of me, encouraging me, and you can make it. It's encouraging me. It said, I don't feel like going on this morning. You said, listen to me very carefully. You got to muster up enough strength and say, God, I'm going to enter to your house. God, I'm here to listen to your word because I'm going through. The enemy don't want you to come in and be among the saints of God. He wants you to stay out and have a pity party. He wants you to get out there by yourself so he can talk to you. Don't be afraid to ask for help on this morning. When I was an instructor, they said the first thing you keep in your mind, he said, there's no such thing as a dumb question. If the person have enough option to ask the question, no matter how dumb it might seem to you, no matter how dumb or what response the rest of the people are, you owe them the answer that you have. Glory be to God. And when you finish, you ask them, did I answer the question? And they said, no. He said, hold on just a little while longer. And so it is with the saints of God. It's some things in the word of God that you might not understand, but therefore you ask God. You say, Lord, open up my understanding to the word of God. What are you saying to me on this morning? God is telling the body of Christ, he said, don't be afraid to ask for help for your situation. You will be surprised, because everybody has been told everything they have done. Everybody has been testified as what they've been through. But when you ask for some help, you say, now, Lord, I know what it is that you have me to do. I know why you placed me in such a time as this, for this little bit of moment, 30 minutes of space of time, you might not ever see this individual again. Glory be to God. But for that moment, God has chosen you. And so, saints of God, for this moment that the world is going through, you are a royal priesthood, a chosen generation, for such a time time is this? People are hurting. They're going through. All kinds of thoughts are coming to their minds. But we got the word of God. We can write the divide the word of truth. We can calm a heart that's filled with fear. We can mend a broken heart. Because he said, if there any sick among them, let them call for the elders of the church. He said, they lay hands and they pray with prayer of faith and they commit any sin. He said, they shall be forgiven. So saints of God, remember what God did. He said, when you cast your cares upon me, when you begin to put it on the shoulders of the Lord, God is not going to bend under the weight, but God will stand tall. In other words, when you pile on, anybody ever had to pile on before? When you pile on to God, God said, that's what I want you to do. Don't stop piling on to God, because he said, I promise my God. He said, listen, cast your cares. I care for you. I want you to be free of the very thing that's stopping you from being in the house of God with a praise. We said, I will bless the Lord at all times. Whatever that thing is that's stopping you from blessing God at all times, you need to cast it on the Lord. And when you cast it, you need to walk away from it. Don't try to pick it back up. In other words, get in line and follow God and let God deal with your situation. Saints of God, you've been dealing with it for a long, long, long time. But God has said a long time has finally come to an end, because you now you understand what I'm trying to say to you. Don't be afraid to ask for help on this morning. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Because what happens in the humility that we're supposed to have as people of God, the fear of being humble, the fear of submitting ourselves one to another, it causes an anxiety to say, I gotta put myself, my feelings, my thoughts up to the side and submit and be humble. I gotta put on humility because Christ was humble. When we put on Christ, humility, amen, will not be a problem. So we're saying, Lord, I want to be humble. But he said, you got to cast your cares on me. Because if you're not casting cares on me, it creates them in a situation where you're always worried. And worrying is not of God. God is not giving a spirit of fear, but of power and love and what? Of a sound mind. That thing that's keeping you up, that thing that's bothering you, saints of God, cast your cares. We got a work to do. Glory be to God. Yes, we do. But we got to be humble and submit ourselves one to the other. We got to, amen, feel each other's infirmities. Amen. We got to feel it, amen. And when we feel it, we can help one another. People are coming through these doors, saints of God. They're going to need us like never before. But that need, amen, is being, amen, we got to be able. Not only see, sometimes we're afraid to step down. Step down. They can't get up there where you are. Step down. Step down. Christ, amen, he was with the sinners. And they criticized him for it. He said, I came to seek and to save that which was lost. Those that are well don't need a physician, but those that are what? That are sick. People are sick, and they need us, amen. They need to see the Christ in us. They need, amen, to feel the love. They need, amen, somebody to come alongside to encourage them and say, you can make it. Some people are afraid to ask for help because of how they're going to be treated. What's going to be said about them? Saints of God, just like the confidence we have in God, to take it to the Lord and say, leave it there. God's not going to broadcast it. It's the same thing that they got to have when they come to us. But whatever it is that they're going through, you got to be a vessel, amen, that can receive something, amen, and not got holes in it. Lord have mercy. Huh? When they pour into you, amen, make sure you ain't got holes of gossip. Text it, Facebooking it. So I thought I could trust them. Some of the hurt, amen, is right here in church. Church is the worst kind. Worst kind. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Lord, I need to be humble. I'm working on the work. God said, listen, when you cast it on me, the anxiety begins to go away. That's what it is. People are on some serious medication, anxiety attacks. They have. Because of what they fear and what lies ahead. I don't fear what lies ahead. I know God is still in control.
The sun rose this morning. It tells me God is still in control. It tells me, glory be to God. I know it's Florida, my God, and Texas is devastating, but God is still in control. He's still in control. And whatever we need, God's got it. I was talking to a young lady. Hadn't seen her in a while. She said, praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. How you been? I've been working, going to school, and a lot of things. I could have thought in my mind, excuses. But you know what? When she saw me, she didn't run from me. See, that's how you look at a situation. Like, I saw it, they went the other way. But they run to you. There's no time for me to say, where you been? And, oh, you need to. It's time to listen to what it is that they need. She's a pastor working, doing this and doing that. And I was trying to see if we had afternoon service. You know what that confirmed to me? That we got to get our afternoon service. I know it's once a month. But just, if it's just for one person, I remember, glory be to God, that people used to work in Berlin. See, they couldn't get to morning service, but they got to the afternoon service. See, they had to be faithful to the afternoon service that God has provided for. So when we get afternoon service, it's not just we just go through the motion. Somebody here needs that service. Somebody here needs to hear that word. And we got to be willing and able to do it for them. That's what God, amen, is doing for us. He said, don't be afraid to ask for help. Lord, we need help. We need to be faithful, amen, what God has committed unto us. Lord, I need help. Help us, my God, that we be faithful to what you have called us to do. Because it's easy, amen, to shut the doors and go home. But can you wait for that saint to say, I need a word? I can't get here during morning service, but I can get here in the afternoon. Glory be to God. Can we be that faithful unto God? Because we are helpful saints of God, one to another. Yeah, I can prophesy and speak in tongues, understand all mysteries, but if I don't have the love of God, it profits us what? Nothing. The love of God. The love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by what? By the Holy Ghost. You got the Holy Ghost? You got the love of God. But you got to nourish it. It has to grow. It has to exceed, glory be to God, the righteousness of the Pharisees. Those people that are what? Just doing it for the fashion. Your love for God has got to exceed that. Churches are filled this morning. But they really don't, it's for shape, form, checking the box, I got it done. Getting it done means that, Lord, what do you have me to do? And if God calls you to do something, he will equip you to do it. It's in the house. It's in the house. It's in, tell somebody, it says in the house.
In the house.
But God, I need some help. Sometimes he said, what he said? Lord, help my what? Help my unbelief. Help my unbelief. There's a desire, amen, in God's house. So we got to put on the Lord Jesus Christ, make no provision for the flesh, that we fulfill the lust thereof. Fulfill the lust. God, amen, we're spiritual beings. And God wants to have a spiritual concern about souls. Don't be afraid to ask for help on this morning. Pray my tribute. Thank you.